Welcome back, Internet. Today is an exciting day. If I can be honest, the reason that I started using Linux way back was because I didn't have the money to cough up for creative style applications. Video editors, image editors, graphics tools, all of those things. That is the gateway that brought me to Linux and honestly started this whole channel. You know what? We might not have the Adobe Creative Suite on Linux, and sure, I'm all for it if it was to come to the Linux side of things, but seeing as we don't, here are the alternatives, or what I stumbled across on Twitter the other day, what they are calling the Libre Graphics Suite, and some other things. So today's video, we're going to be looking at all of the alternatives to some of the best professional creative applications out there that you can get your hands on and start using today for free. Honestly, there is so much power and potential wrapped up in these different applications that I've been wanting to make this video for a long time. Today is the day. So get hyped. Like, subscribe. We're gonna smash through as many of these as we possibly can in a short amount of time as possible. Today's episode is brought to you by Skillshare, an online learning platform with over 25,000 courses, 7 million users, and you could be one of them. Check out the link in the description for 2 free months of Skillshare Premium and stick around to the end of the video for 2 recommendations for some of the applications that we're looking at in this video today. Let's get it. Okay, first off, a little bit of context. Right now, on this desktop, I'm running Ubuntu 18.04.3, I think we're on. All of these applications that I have installed are either from the FlatHub repository packaged as a Flatpak, or they are available as app images. This means that no matter what Linux distribution you're running, and chances are even if you're running Windows or Mac, you can go out and get these applications. All right, let me show you where all this started. There is a fantastic list up on GitHub, and it's from the App Image Kit team. And they have the Libre Graphics Suite. And so they have a commercial list, or they have a list of commercial applications, and then they have the Libre Graphics equivalent next to it. And what we will be doing is flying through these applications as quickly as possible, and I will give them kind of a rating. Now, I am not the best when it comes to using all of these applications to their fullest potential. Really, the ones that I have the most experience in are GIMP and KdenLive, and dabbling in some of the other ones. There are some of these applications that I have barely touched. So all that said and done, let us kick off the list with Inkscape. Inkscape is a vector graphics editor. It has a bunch of fantastic tools and features. But when it comes to creating scalable vector graphics using a computer, Inkscape is the way to go. Honestly, this is one of the most venerable open source applications. It has the ability to handle all of the industry standard formats. So if you're looking to create graphics for website design, or if you're looking to create mockups, or if you're looking to create basically anything that's not raster-based graphics, then Inkscape is going to be the way to go. This would be the equivalent to Adobe Illustrator. Now, when we're looking at what kind of stuff you can do with this particular program, what I would suggest you do is go onto the Inkscape website and select the gallery, and you'll start to get a really cool idea of just how much Inkscape is capable of. I mean, we've got a freaking hamburger here. Okay, moving right along, we have the equivalent of Adobe InDesign, which is Scribus or Scribus. I'm not really sure how you say it, but desktop publishing. Believe it or not, this is still actually a thing that people want to do. To be able to have a tool that can handle different color spaces, different printing profiles, and ICC color profiles, this is all something that is very specific to desktop publishing, but also to online publishing, whether it's ebooks and that kind of thing. So Scribus is where that side of things can come in. They do have a couple of examples of magazines and books that have been produced by Scribus in the past, but honestly, some of these examples are a little bit old. They also have a couple of templates built into the application itself, and the application does look a little long in the tooth, But from what I've heard and the very little that I've dabbled around in this application, it is pretty powerful. So if you're looking to create a newsletter or anything that's going to be printed out and has a lot of different text and images involved and they need to stay centered and set, or you're looking to import PDF elements, then Scribus should definitely be one that you check out. Doesn't look as modern as Adobe InDesign, I will grant, but still can get the job done if you're in a pickle. The next one that absolutely blows my mind with how much people have achieved with this application is Krita. Krita is a digital painting tool, and again, can operate in multiple color spaces, whether it's the CYMK one or the RGB one. And they have everything from like different brushes, support for graphics tablets. Honestly, there is so much potential packed into Krita. Krita is probably at one of the top open source graphic design applications out there in terms of what it can do and the performance of it. So it'd be very similar to something like Painter on the commercial side of things. And I just wish I had some sick artwork of mine to show you, because I can't draw whatsoever. So jumping onto their website, they have a fantastic gallery, and they also have artist interviews that have covered the whole like creative process and how different artists utilize the tools within Krita to get their stuff done. Honestly, people using computers and free and open source software to realize their creative vision is just so dang inspiring to me. It's unbelievable. Okay, on to territory that is very familiar to me. That is Caden Live. Caden Live is a video editor that is very straightforward. It's very much like Premiere or Sony Vegas. And that's Sony Vegas was where I started cutting my teeth on video editing, or at least professional video editing. And honestly, Caden Live is the tool that I use to create pretty much everything you see on this YouTube channel. So I've become a huge fan of Caden Live over the years. And honestly, it has gone from strength to strength with each and every release. Be doing a lot better once I tell Caden Live where I threw all its video clips. Okay. So Caden Live, I've talked about this in the past, but honestly, go out and use it. If you are trying to get video editing happening on the Linux side of things, Caden Live is honestly your best option right now, in my opinion. There is exciting potential on the horizon for projects like Olive, and definitely go check that one out. But it's still very much in alpha, and it's having features added to it all the time. Still a great application, but for right now, Caden Live is the mature option. Now, I did briefly want to mention FontForge. If you're into designing fonts at all, then FontForge is going to be able to help you out with that. Again, I'm not really into this at all, but it's just good to know that it exists. So if you're trying to design your own custom font, go ahead. FontForge should be able to help you out with that. All right, let's talk music. When it comes to music, look no further than the Linux multi... What does it stand for? I don't even know anymore. LMMS. Is what this application is. It's basically the equivalent of GarageBand or kind of Logic Pro-ish. And man, this thing can produce some fantastic results for an application that doesn't cost you anything. So I've loaded up just a project that I found on their sharing hub, which, by the way, if you are trying to figure out just what this program is capable of, they have a fantastic sharing platform on their website. You can go and download the project files that other people have contributed to the website for free, which I think is really, really cool. So having a look around here in LMMS, you have a lot of the familiar tool sets, such as piano rolls, such as automation pads, all of that kind of thing that you can use to create the ideal track for you. I have no idea how loud this is going to be. Might turn that down a little bit. But honestly, it's pretty sick what you can do and what you can achieve with LMMS. Now, if you wanted to go for something a little more granular and you want to be able to have a lot more control over organically recording instruments and vocals, then Ardour is the application you're going to want to check out. This is very similar to something like Adobe Audition, or actually it's probably a little bit more powerful than that even, because Ardour is meant to get you from the start to the finish of a project, whether it's mixing, editing, recording. I realize I just said those three things in a very different order, but Ardour is very, very powerful. So if you're looking to take your music production up a notch, then Ardour will be able to get you there, as opposed to some of the more simple programs that are more based on synthetic instruments and programming music as opposed to recording it and mixing it. Which leads us right on to the next one, which again is another app that I use an awful lot, and that is Audacity. Audacity has been around for so long now, and it's one of the most venerable, top-rated, wonderful open source applications out there. This is what you would compare to Adobe Audition or SoundForge Pro or something like that. There's just so many well-tested and polished plugins. You can use the LADSPA plugins on LMMS and on Audacity. So Audacity is very, very powerful. If you haven't heard of it yet, what are you doing with your life? Go and download it. If you're into podcasting, if you're into recording your voice at all, Audacity or anything else for that matter, Audacity is going to be the one to help you out. Okay, let's talk photos. RAW therapy. Honestly, there are so many good options for a Lightroom, Adobe Lightroom alternative. And RAW therapy, I think, is the one that ticks the most boxes when it comes to the design of the application, how often it's updated, and how fast its workflow is. Now, I am not a professional photographer, but I have used both Darktable and Digicam before, and these are both very, very good alternatives. So if you want a few to try, then go do that. But I believe, and photographers, feel free to jump into the comment section, I feel like RAW therapy has one of the most polished, complete packages out there. So definitely go check it out. It can handle literally almost any image you throw at it, and the amount of granular detail you can get over your photos, as well as doing batch edits, as well as doing exports. There is just so much to love in RAW therapy. It's actually a bit of a hidden gem, I think. Okay, we need to talk about the big ones. We need to talk about GIMP. GIMP is amazing. The GNU image manipulation program, and this is what I use almost every week to make the thumbnails. Teaser alert for upcoming videos. GIMP would be the equivalent of Adobe Photoshop. Its biggest downfall is that it doesn't support the CYMK color space and a few other industry standards, which does hold it back a little bit. Now let's talk 3D stuff. And for 3D, you cannot go wrong with an application like Blender. Blender is one of the open source flagship applications. And honestly, there is very little that you can't do with this particular application. Now, the only time I've ever messed around with it is in its video editing capacities. I know, it even has a built-in video editor. It's a very stable, well-used, well-loved application all around the world. It is unbelievable what people have been able to pull off using Blender to create full-length animated movies. Look, honestly, jump onto blender.org, go and have a look at the showcase of some of the stuff that they have. It is ridiculous. And the amount of funding that the Blender project is getting to support game developers is just inspiring. Like, I'm getting goosebumps talking about it. That's how exciting it is. Now, if 2D animation is more your thing, then go and check out Synfig Studio, because you can do keyframe animations and 2D animations with vector graphics really, really easily. Well, not really easily. It's still a laborious creative process, but Synfig Studio can get you in that space without having to shell out a huge amount of money. It's actually so cool how 2D animation works these days when it comes to computer animated 2D animation. And Synfig is one powerful bit of software. And I reckon that just about covers it. My goodness, so many top quality open source creative applications out there. I'm almost tempted to say, who needs the Adobe Suite? But industry standards and all that, I get it. But let me know what is your favorite creative application that is free and open source software in the comments below. And I want to give a big shout out to today's sponsor, which is Skillshare. Skillshare is one of the leading online learning communities for creative professionals, business entrepreneurs, you name it. There are so many different types of courses to advance your skill set and advance your creative capabilities. And I'm going to outline just a couple of them. And there are honestly so many courses available for some of the programs that I've mentioned in today's episode. And I just want to highlight just a few of them. First of all, you've got the Blender 2.8 series that is done by Film VFX. And this is talking about how to make the most of Blender, the 3D rendering program. There's also Digital Painting with Critter. If you want to get started with digital painting, this guy also has a course on Blender as well. And also there is a fantastic one on design vector graphics with Inkscape, and it's version 2.0 of this particular course because he's had some updates to add since the first one came out. So definitely go check these courses out. But honestly, there are so many more. Videography, entrepreneurship, productivity, whatever it is, Skillshare will be able to help you grow as a creative professional. And Skillshare Premium gives you unlimited access to all of these courses for less than 10 bucks a month. But you can go and check out the link in the description for 2 months of free Skillshare Premium using the link below. So go check it out. You've literally got nothing to lose doing this, and you might even be able to learn in depth one of the fantastic free and open source applications that I've mentioned today. So special thanks to Skillshare once again for sponsoring today's episode. So please share this video around if you know creatives that are up and coming that want to get their hands dirty with almost professional level applications, and in some cases, some of the best professional applications out there. Because I reckon the more that we can spread the love around for these open source applications, the more that desktop Linux adoption will be taken pretty seriously. This is the reason that I use Linux, literally. It is the reason that I started using it. So thank you all so much for watching and supporting the channel. I really appreciate it. Thumbs and subs and all that good stuff. And I will see you in the very next video. Peace.